Welcome to the Stanley Cup Playoffs, presented by Geico. On a beautiful Saturday night, the series comes north to San Jose. It's game number three, Western Conference Semifinals, the Los Angeles Kings and the San Jose Sharks. As the captains prepare, Joe Thornton and the Sharks, a must win at home, a building where they've lost only twice all season. Dustin Brown and the Kings, they hung on to their home ice in the series by winning the first two. Now they get set to step into a hostile environment. Now the Battle of California heads north. It's desperation time for the Sharks. Game three is next. A wonderful atmosphere tonight inside HP Pavilion as we get set for game number three of this Western Conference semifinal.
But he said to beat LA, you have to play at an elite level in all areas.
These late game heroics by Los Angeles have been impressive. Throughout the playoffs, the puck is sent out of play, and we will have a penalty right off the hop.
And look for them to try and move the puck to the middle.
They are 0 for 7 in the series, but not now. Danny Boyle with a rocket. Quick doesn't like it. San Jose is off and running.
Guys are grown. I think when you play in a lot of games, obviously there's some veterans here, but some of our younger guys got some experience last year in the first round. Being late, being down late twice against Vancouver, I think was good for us. I think that's a pressure situation. We come back both games, and tonight getting a start early was key. The power play, also getting a goal early was key. And again, I think experience allows you to play in pressure situations, and you know, that comes with experience.
Get it deep, quick in the trapezoid, lays it there for Slavovoynov. Heavy hit as TJ Cagliardi was taken down in back of that Los Angeles goal.
That by Jonathan Quick.
Even terms on the ice as Carter's out of the box. Now Antti Niemi will set the breakup, the breakout, I should say, here. Now a turnover, and they score! Tyler Toffoli with a steal on his backhand. He's tied it. Now it's played here by Justin Williams, hit hard. Brad Stewart, a big time hit.
Having your old bowel Cronwall there.
Yeah, I learned from the master. So, it's a play that I've seen him do quite a few times. You know, the forward looks up, thinks he's got some time, and then you make your move. And he didn't see me coming, I don't think, until it was probably too late. And I think it was a good hit. I mean, I haven't seen a replay, but I think it was good.
This goes down. Kings in control. Brown with a shot. Good block. Logan Couture stung by it. Dustin Brown. Easy chance for Antti Niemi. That'll do it. Level ground after one in game three. At the end of period one, Jeff Carter walks in, sends it wide. Mike Richards in control. And an injured Shark in back of Antti Niemi, it's Scott Hannon. Sharks have it. Logan Couture given a shove by Jeff Carter. Couture now slow to get up.
Lost. He hurt his left hand or his wrist and now limping as well.
Muzzin one more time. Doughty, a wrister. Covered by Niemi. Lost it for a brief second and recovered. Goes inside. Pavelski out in front. What a save by Quick! Desjardins had the chance. Pavelski again detected by Justin Williams.
Here's Logan Couture. Has just come back to the bench. As soon as the whistle went, he jumped on the ice, had a quick spin. And that's great news if you're a San Jose Sharks fan.
Couture holding on to it for the outside. 1 second left as the horn goes at the Shark Tank. We stay tied at one after 40. Thornton now goes to work on Scuderi. This is Slavovoynov, Richards, and Gomez out of the box. Thornton wipes it wide on a steal. Irwin at the point for San Jose. Scott Gomez, Brad Richardson for the Kings. Pulls up. Back in front. Niemi said no on Penner, and he handles that one from Kopitar. Now Gomez. Wing goes. It's loose. Good poke check by Quick. And a penalty is called.
Robin Regier, I believe, will get the, I believe it's a hooking penalty.
Short-handed, Trevor Lewis, Mike Richards, here they come. Richards has it. Second chance, what a block. Boyle, and a penalty is called. Lewis crashing the goal with 3.2 seconds left.
The home team has won the majority of these games, and here, the average length of overtime in this playoffs has been 8 minutes and 19 seconds. OT starts after this break.
From the corner, Thornton. One man out of the box, it's Regeer. In deep it goes, Thornton. Marlowe, Couture, he scores! Logan Couture wins it for San Jose, and they climb back in.
Todd, how is Logan doing? He wasn't, you know, obviously available to us afterwards getting treatment, and also obviously how that left the game.
Logan is, you know, he got banged up a little bit, obviously, but he came back and was able to play, and obviously we're very thankful for that. Marty is injured again.